Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Blind. I'm here with Parvati. And, we gotta figure out what to do. How we can get these guys back. Meaning the people at the greenhouse? Botanical Lab. I don't want to cut out their power, like Thompson wants us to do. That would be very bad. How about not force them? Can I talk to Grace about it?
What is it?
Nope. All right. I think the only person we can talk to is about it is Abigail. Excuse me, chicken.
Oh gosh. It's so pretty.
Yeah, you like it in here, huh?
Yeah, huh?
No, nothing. Alright. Hi.
I'm listening.
Reed sent me to make peace with you.
Reed Thompson? You here on behalf of that cold-eyed reptile? Let's hear it. What's Reed's idea of peace, then?
Reed asked you to consider coming back to town. He's willing to make amends.
Make amends? Spare me. Only thing Reed knows how to make is a mess. Like everything else that comes out of Edgewater, that peace offering is canned. I and my own are living just fine out here by ourselves.
This is gonna be a hard sell. Reed asked me to divert your power over to him. He mentioned a geothermal plant.
He would do such a thing. The question is, why would you agree to his plans?
Well, your camp has a power regulator, which I need to repair my ship.
Cannery's got a regulator. You want ship parts, you ought to rip them out of the cannery's guts and leave us be. If you're going down to the plant, you should divert power away from Edgewater and toward our end of the grid. Think about it. You'd be liberating an entire town from a lifetime of service to that odious cannery. Seems the sort of thing a hero would do.
What have you got against the town?
You've seen that miserable excuse for a town with your own lamps. Hollowed out workers laboring their lives away at the cannery, living off whatever scrap Spacer's choice throws them. You know that's true, don't you, Ms. Holcomb? Your father died of overwork. His heart gave out.
Oh, really?
He was tired all the time, sure, but he was old, ma'am, and he raised me all by his lonesome.
Look what they did to this child. Lost her family to the company, and still she defends them.
I don't much like you throwing that in her face to get me on her side. To get me on your side.
All right. I ain't so fragile.
That was unkind of me. I'm sorry, dear.
Let's say I help you. What happens to Edgewater?
Life in Edgewater grinds to a halt. The cannery shuts down, workers desert in droves, and our own little camp grows and thrives.
You think Reed's just trying to spite you?
You bring power to Reed's town, and you'll be killing us. Reed knows it. He's counting on it.
I'll consider it.
I trust you will listen to your conscience.
Well, I'm not sure what to do.
Yeah, huh?
Anything else I can do for you?
When we first talked, you'd assumed I'd come to live here.
I am getting old, you know. These two lamps of mine are not as bright as they once were. Or I might have seen you for what you are.
And what's that?
Remains to be seen. Might be the woman that saves the veil. Might be Reed's personal gun hand.
Save the veil?
People around here lack the strength to effect change. Or they have the strength, but not the will. You seem to have both.
Why are you telling me all this?
A little prattling never hurt anyone, dear. You might even catch a little sense, if you listen close enough. I can't stop you from conducting your business down at the plant. I just want you to know that if you take our power away, you will have brought an end to our way of life.
You could always continue your way of life back in town.
Not under Reed's watch. He and I would come to blows within a day, and he would never tolerate my tending to a garden. This is my home. It will be my home even if Reed cuts our power. Simple as that.
You and Reed obviously have some sort of history.
That's because Reed was my boss. I was the cannery's one and only flavor specialist, you see. Remember that limited run of white chocolate saltuna? That was all me.
Looks like her hair is made out of feathers. there's obviously more to it than that.
My son worked in that cannery. When the plague started coming, he was one of the first to fall sick. We had a store of medicine locked away, but Reed refused to treat him. Said my boy didn't deserve treatment. Said the medicine would have been wasted on him. So I buried my boy in the cemetery, gathered my belongings, and left. That's as much of the story as you need to hear.
I'm guessing Reed has his own side of that story, though.
I could not possibly care less if he does. But you're surely welcome to ask him. I'm listening.
All right. Not sure.
Where are we headed?
Something I can help you with?
I was hoping something would come up. I don't see any option.
Oh. He used to follow me around before he left the cannery.
Over here?
Keep your wits about you, friend.
Keep your wits about you, friend.
Thomas. Is this Thomas over here? Is that his name? This is Thomas. I have two of your books.
Any luck finding one of those manuals?
Whoa, Miss Parvati. How are you? Hi. Hello.
Are you, good God. Things safe out here? How are you keeping?
Great, just great. I've been trying to keep stuff running, just like you. Only I'm not so... Wait, they didn't kick you out, did they?
Oh gosh, no. I'm just along with this lady here.
Wait, one of the data pads. I've got two of them. Today's your lucky day, Thomas. I've got one of the data pads you wanted.
No kidding. Really? Well, which one?
Alright, we've got separate. Okay. Part one, found it in the community center archives.
Look at that. Building a computing machine out of spectrum potatoes, a primer. I'm just glad it survived all these years. I appreciate you going through all that trouble. One data pad's enough to guide me down my newfound path. Just remember, I got something saved for you if you find me all three.
They're now friendly. Nice. Well, hold on. I've got more for you.
Well, don't keep me in suspense.
Part two, found it in the cannery.
Ain't that just ironical? If I'd worked a little longer back at the cannery, I might have found this myself. Two whole data pads? Be still my beating heart.
Oh, almost forgot your payment.
Sweet. Didn't I get 300 for the other one? So I saw it wrong. I'll let you know if I find any others.
Sure. I'd be glad to take them off your hands. What's on your mind? Couple months. This camp's my home. I owe them my life. Would have died in the wilderness if they...
Never mind.
Something you need?
He's standing right there.
Something you need?
Thomas seemed very fond about you. Or of you.
He's just interested in fixing stuff. He always used to follow me around, asking me to explain what I was doing. Like a puppy, kinda.
Third option. Are you sure? He nearly fell over when he saw you.
He never told me a word to that effect. And since he didn't, I didn't have to say nothing about being... about feeling different. And nothing had to get weird. If he wants to learn about engineering, we should help him get those data pads he wants. I'd like to do that for him.
Oh, I've only got one left. Let's get back to it. Alright. Oops, sorry about that. Delivered Reed's message, but Adelaide refused to return to Edgewater. Head to the geothermal plant and redirect the power. Adelaide proposed that you divert the geothermal plant's output to the botanical lab, depriving Edgewater of power. This is in geothermal plant as well. That's in some cave. I wonder where I find... my reputation here. Okay, so deserters is now friendly. On track to being a great employee. You are friendly to this faction. Vendors' prices are reduced by 15%. So I wonder if we're now friendly if I get another option when I talk to Adelaide. Or if it's just too late for that. Maybe I should return the books first. Oh, I'm in the bathroom. Did I even see this area? Adelaide? You guys like me more now.
I'm listening.
So wait, where is this plant? Geothermal Master Control Terminal. Is it this? Objective, yeah. I think we've been over there. Oh, wait. Where's your machine? Hold up. Because I have this thing, right? It's something I can add to my weapon, I think? Tinker. So what's this? What's the difference between modifying and tinkering? Extendo site. Gyro site. Oh, if you install this modification, the current one will be destroyed. Okay, never mind. I can't talk to her about this.
What is it?
Been here, haven't I? Maybe, maybe not. Oh yeah, everything is pretty much. I think I just missed that. That light ammo. Yeah, I've been here. Or someone has. Oh, that? Oh, jeez. How could I miss that? Orthrus? There's a whole bunch of those things. Oops! Ow.
That's the last of them.
All right. She's pretty helpful. Got an Adrena Time necklace. A toss ball card, Tyson Christensen. Christensen is known for the least number of bronzes past the hump. Hey, whatever that is. Power grip mod, look at all this stuff. Tactical shotgun. Sold by Hammersmith as a short range, high spread weapon. This gun works very well in the hands of people with little training. Is that so? Energy cells and bit cartridge. Oh. Assistant. Ethology log. Hunting behavior of feral canids. My name is Kane Von Acker. I am a Spacer's Choice ethologist specializing in the fauna of Terra 2. Currently, I am studying the hunting behavior of feral canids. I managed to find a nice hiding spot beside a rather large pack of canids. This is the largest pack of feral canids I've ever seen in the Vale. In a sufficiently large pack, canids will hunt just about anything. This pack could probably take down a small group of primals, given the chance. Smaller packs tend to give a wider berth to the primals roaming this region. Sprats and terror rays, however, are fair game for even a lone canid. They may not have encountered primals, but this pack of canids makes quick work of a marauder camp they found. I'm afraid I may have to move on before I can study this pack closely. I'll have to leave my things for one of my assistants to pick up later. Oh, man. That assistant. Pretty brutal. So she's fine. Look at that up there. That's my extendo sight. I think I like the extendo sight. A flywheel. A small metal device used to store rotational energy. Fun science fact, if you ever wondered why it's hard to push over a functioning auto-mechanical, but it's easy to tip over a non-functioning one, this little device is the reason. Okay. That's the marauders he mentioned that were taken out. Parts. A backpack. Plus 20 kilograms. What does Oops. Energy canister. This energy canister holds the power cells from an automechanical. Automechanical energy canisters have been standardized in size and shape for decades, allowing them to be used in automechanicals of all types. This one appears depleted. we're not gonna be fighting a lot of auto mechanicals here. Wow. Pretty generous with the XP just by walking near places. Combat drone.
Around in here.
Well, now we got our chance. I don't think we should be going through there, though. Mechanical guardian. And then where's the drone? Sentry drone. Oh boy.
Performing an area spread. Concluded. No dissidents found.
Nah. Dissidents are right here. Can I get through another way? I can go through there.
Unexpected.
Thanks. Apparently the others weren't alerted. I say apparently. Shiny servo. The servo appears bright and shiny as if it were brand new or recently well cleaned. You would be proud to let it fulfill any of your servo-related needs. Anything else of interest back here? Water. Okay, I got some room. Let's see. Look at all the mag picks I got. Look at all the bypass shunts I have. Got back here. Some dead canids. Something's that way. The bright and fluffy tail of an adult canid. The tail is long and whip-like, and the consistency of the tail covering is somewhere between furry and feathered. Yeah. Dead scientist. So is this some kind of hologram? I know I can tell her where to go, but I haven't messed with that yet. Makeshift low pressure suit. Compass. Junk item. What does all this say? Scientist notes? Emerald Vale Geothermal Plant. Power Plant Security Terminal. Please enter a command. Alright, before I disarm anything, let's view the recent logs. Accessing. Error. Security logs inaccessible. In keeping with Spacer's Choice Company policy, all security logs have been terminated in the event of a major emergency, catastrophic event, or security breach. Attention! Scheduled security updates at this Spacer's Choice facility are critically overdue. Your last scheduled security update occurred on error, date not found. If you are a member of the Spacer's Choice security detail assigned to this location, please turn in your identification for immediate reprimand. Failure to do so may result in an immediate reprimand. Gotta love it. Alright, that's it for logs then? Okay. Disarm security fences. Disarmed. Now I wonder if these auto mechanicals are going to respond to that. Mechanical Guardian Mark 1.